This is Pillsbury State Park, located partially in Washington and partially in Goshen, New Hampshire. Named for its benefactor guy who gave the land. Alfred Pillsbury was his name. He was born and grew up in Milford, New Hampshire, in a house up on High Street. His house is, in fact, directly across the street from the house that I grew up in, so I know of him. He was born into a family of abolitionists. The family was part of the Underground Railroad during the Civil War. They harbored many escaped slaves on their way to Canada. And Albert himself was his whole life an advocate of racial equality. He was, in fact, a member of the National Negro Committee, which was the precursor to the NAACP. For this and other work, Albert Pillsbury was awarded an honorary doctorate of law from Howard University, and the speech he gave at the ceremony that day was later published. It's still in print. It is entitled Lincoln and Slavery. As you see, I own a copy. Albert Pillsbury also became a prominent lawyer in Boston. He made a lot of money in 1905. He purchased the land and logging rights here in Cherry Valley. His ambition was to do lumbering with great respect for the regrowth and forest itself. Earlier, he had been a founding member of the Society for the Protection of New Hampshire Forest. And in 1921, he gave this entire tract of land to the state of New Hampshire. It stood unimproved over the years until 1933. The Civilian Conservation Corps made great improvements to the trails and the dams and the ponds, and today the park is part of a 50-mile-long greenway that extends from Mount Monadnock to Lake Sunapee. Still, Pillsbury remains among the lesser-known state parks. This fact makes it the best place for people who want camping and hiking and canoeing the way it used to be. There are no amenities here. No camp store, no activities, no modern toilets even. If you want Disneyland, it ain't here. But if you yearn to get away from the rat race, this is the place. Pillsbury encompasses 8,000 acres in all, 7 ponds, 41 campsites, canoes and kayaks for rent. Well, I'm going to stop now because, frankly, I don't want to make this place seem too good. Too many people coming here would take away the very thing I love about the place, solitude. Pillsbury has that in spades.